Part 9. Acceptance of Subjugation. Democracy in its contemporary meaning is of Greek origin, though translated from Latin it means populism. The general election is actually giving the right to use violence to those who promise to offend people different from you and to share the things taken away from them. The main point in engaging people in elections with predetermined results is to create the feeling of involvement. This is a symbolic acceptance of one's own submission. Many entrepreneurs will generally approve the governmental redistribution of funds and opportunities because their business was adapted to this and makes a profit. A demagogue is able to persuasively streamline any action, however, this is a negative amount gain. The volume of assets taken away using the threat of violence exceeds the volume of voluntary exchange. In addition to taxes, government loans also grow. Politicians promise voters and their creditors the property which doesn't belong to them, but which is planned to be taken away from others. The Laffer curve shows politicians under what circumstances they can deprive the population of their assets in greater amounts. It's no different from the science describing ways to get more milk and meat from cows. The crowd approving racketeering will eventually become poorer and angrier. Under dictatorship, it's possible to force people to work or turn the whole country into a big concentration camp. However, if this form of amenity production were efficient, it would have superseded other forms. In the criminal environment, leaders are chosen as well. Not everyone participates in the elections, but it doesn't eradicate violence. In its character, such an organization includes extortion as a means of enrichment. The criminal authority electors are the interested recipients of the promised benefits. The judge's point of view is determined by his employer. It's sometimes even easier to tolerate the injustice of a tyrant than the injustice spawned by the general public. It's natural for children to be dependent and to obey. Imagine a democratic system in a family of 2 adults and 3 school children. The parents will have to submit to the ignorant majority. By the way, although all people were once children, they grow up and stop understanding what is children's rights. After all, when speaking of the children's rights, the rights of adults are actually approved authorization to limit the children's rights and to force kids into the specified behavior. The authorities are a little bit cleverer than their electorate, and they treat their people the same way adults treat children, forgetting that once they were children as well.